Welcome back everyone to some more Elite Dangerous. Today we're going to be going over the galaxy map and its trade routes that it shows us. Elite Dangerous's map is very, very, very detailed and also very confusing at first glance. I looked at it on my first glance and thought, I am never going to understand that. However, when you delve into a little bit more, it's actually very simple. You just need to understand the very basics and then you can use this map to your advantage, mainly trading ones. That is what this video is going to be mainly about. However, I'm not going to be detailing any amazing trade routes that I've discovered. I'm just going to be showing you how you can find your own trade routes. As I said, the system is huge. Look at this. You can find a million trade routes near and there will still be more to pick from. So what we're going to do right now is just go over to the very basics of what you need to do to browse the galaxy map and to use it to your advantage. So this is a video on that and hopefully it can help you. So let's just get into it. The navigation tab is used to quickly get around the galaxy map. So for instance, at the top, if you want to search for a system name, if you know specifically and want to see what it looks like and what's around it, click and type. Click the button next to it and it's going to take you directly there. Sol is actually our solar system in this game. Very cool. And it will also show you the route as well for that, possibly. Current location is where we currently are. If you just click that button, it's going to take you directly there. Destination, I never really use. And jump data, you can flicker between economical routes, fastest routes, and also what cargo mass and how far you can jump with that cargo. So these are all very useful. However, mainly you want to be using search and current location to quickly get around the map. Very useful if you know where you're off and what you need to do. Okay, so flicking onto the options tab quickly, you can see you have a few options to choose from, basically showing grid, showing navigation markers, which is also where we are located and what destination we've chosen. You can also have a look at star names, switch them off if you're not interested. Region markers as well, and constellations also, flicking them on and off. So the view tab details two modes. One is a realistic mode. This is pretty much just the view tab off. If you want to actually see trade routes though, click map and you're going to see exports and imports for systems that you've been in or currently in or that you've purchased trade data for. So for instance, I haven't been in LHS 64, but if I want to see its exports and imports not related to Shimaku, I can purchase trade data and it's going to show me what it's related to. I imagine it's exporting to Wolf 1080 and Hatch and some other ones that you can't directly travel to from that system. So if we scroll up on the sidebar, you can see that you can sort filters by allegiance, population, government, economy, cartographic shops, and trade data. And switching them, it's not really useful too much. I can't find a use for it unless you're trading specifically for, say, the Federation. I think the system is Federation, so there you go. And Federation mainly trade routes, simple to understand. So, exports and imports. How do you know which is an export? How do you know which is an import? Very simple. The dotted, or as you can see, the lines moving away from Shimaku with the little dot, those are exports. The ones moving into Shimaku, for instance, from Suguru, I can actually unselect that. You can see it's actually importing that. I believe that's waste of some sort. So this, so Shimaku mainly imports waste. It mainly exports. I think that's chemicals. The colours directly relate to a material. So as you can see, metals are orange, minerals are red, and so on and so forth. So with the purple lines moving away from Shimaku, you can see it's either chemicals or engineered ceramics. I don't think it's ceramics, no, so it's chemicals. And as you can see as well, you see when I select off chemicals, it actually shows green lines. These are narcotic agents. These are its secondary export. It mainly deals with chemicals, which is why it shows mainly the chemical lines. It likes to show you the main thing that the system exports. It doesn't just export chemicals, it's going to export also narcotic agents mainly as well. When you select off them, you're also going to see that it exports food as well, and that is also the last thing it produces, as well as textiles as well. It does a little bit of everything, usually does, but generally the things that it exports, they're going to be cheaper to buy in the commodities market. The things that it imports are going to be the more expensive thing to buy. Also guys, you can click the arrow next to a category to drop down the menu and you can see specifically what it's producing. So for instance, the chemicals that Shimaku produces are hydrogen fuel and mineral oil. It doesn't produce any explosives or pesticides. So if you go into the commodities market and pick up some hydrogen fuel or mineral oil, you're going to be picking it up cheaper than you would at the places that it exports to. Okay, so that is pretty much it for the galaxy map. As you can see, you've watched like a 7-minute video and you understand a lot more about it. I'm going to do a video, as I said, on some more trading in-depth videos. So there's that. Make sure to subscribe for it and I'll see you next time. Goodbye.